Each PI archive file consists of a series of 1K records. So these 1 kilobyte records can be divided into what we call primary records and overflow records. And typically, I think it's best to think of the primary records being something that gets generated at the very beginning of your archive file. So let's just pretend that this represents an archive file. You know, this right here is an archive file that represents, let's say, 100 megabytes in size. Okay. What we're going to do is, at the very beginning of this archive file, we're going to create a primary record for each one of the tags in the PI system that are currently in the PI system. So, for example, let's say you had a 10,000 tag system. With a 10,000 tag system, if you use the algorithm I suggested before, 10 to 100K per tag, that ends up being, at a minimum, a 100 megabyte archive. So with a 100 megabyte archive, 100 megabytes, that's 100 million bytes, that's actually 100,000 1K records. You know, basically, you're going to have a 1K record stretching from record number, let's go with record number 1 over here, to record number 100,000 over here. So 100,000 1K records is 100 megabytes. Well, we're going to occupy the beginning of this, or the first portion of this, in these primary records, one record per tag in the system. So if we have 10,000 tags, that means the first 10,000 records here are going to be primary records. Now, at this point, some of you may say, well, why in the world do we care about this? There's actually a point at which this may become an issue. There can be a maximum of 50% of all of these 1K records here. A maximum of 50% of them can be used for primary records. So that means that 50% has to be big enough to hold a primary record for each tag in the system. So that means here, if I were to try to go to, let's say, 50,000 tags, that's not a problem. If I look at 50,000 tags, that would get to just about halfway within these 100,000 records. If I were to try to go greater than that, go to, say, 70,000 tags, at that point you're going to have a bit of a problem, because that's beyond 50% of the size of that. So if you remembered my algorithm, I said 10K per tag, or it ends up being about 10 megabytes at a minimum per 1,000 tags. See, with that algorithm, you should never run into a problem, because with this 10,000 point system, that's 100 megabytes by default, we would suggest, as the minimum size. And as you can see, with the 10,000 point system, it's sized right there to go all the way up to 50,000 tags if for some reason the system grows larger. So it's a fairly minor point, but I do want to point out that the PI archives do have that one restriction. It's a fairly minor restriction. Now, let's talk about what's in that 1K record. The 1K record consists of some header information, as you can see right here. 26 bytes of header information, which is things like the point ID and the zero and the span, etc. And then the rest of this is simply where we store the data. So the data is going to be stored in here in little increments, and the increments are going to be sized based on the type of tag that it is. So, for example, if you're working with an int16 or a digital, the data is going to be stored in 3 bytes. If it's a float 32, it'll be 5 bytes. Float 64 will be 9 bytes. And so, using those numbers, using this 998 bytes of actual storage space, then for a typical float 32, we're going to be able to store about 200 events in each 1K record. So sometimes people ask, how much data can I store in my archives? Well, you now have the ability to calculate that. Just basically look at what you're storing, how much space we have per 1K record, and you can do the calculation. There are times when you're looking at your archives, you actually see information about things like primary records and overflow records. So I'd like to explain briefly what they are and how they fill. When you first create an archive and register that archive, as I've described up here, you first create that. That's not going to, at this point, no primary records are created at that point. You simply have an empty file with no primaries generated at this point. Now, when we shift into that archive, when the Pi server has now shifted because the previous primary archive is full, then at that point we need to initialize this new archive. And at that very point, when we initialize that for the first time, then we create the primary records that go for that archive or that are going to be associated with that archive. So if you've got a 10,000 tag system, then at the point at which you shift into this previously empty archive, now you're going to have 10,000 primary records allocated for that archive. But they're not filled yet. Now, as time goes on, within a few minutes of doing that allocation, within a few minutes you're going to notice that those primary records are going to start to fill up. So each one of these primary records goes with a different Pi tag. So let's say that's one tag, temperature transmitter, we'll start putting data into that tag. And here's a second tag, and a third tag, and a fourth tag. It's not in any particular order, it's just as the data comes in, we're going to start filling up these primary records. So, and as you can imagine, some of these things are going to fill fairly quickly, and some of them are going to fill slowly. So for example, if that's a lab input tag right there, it may only get one value every day. So just gradually as time goes on, you know, during the day, we're going to be filling these primary records. Now at some point, we're going to get to a point, let's just go forward in time here. At some point, we'll get to a point where one of these Pi tags has completely filled up its primary record. So at that point, there is no more room for data to go into that primary record. So what we do at that point is we generate what we call an overflow record. These records that you see over here, these records are the overflow records. Now, we don't start by generating as many as you see right here in red. No, what we end up doing, we start by generating a single overflow record for that primary record that filled. So as I said before, let's say this primary record fills completely. At that point in time, we're going to then generate an overflow record. We'll create this record and then start filling that. And when that record fills completely, we're going to generate another overflow record. So let's say we've got these primary records that are all filling. And as these records fill, we're going to generate some overflow records. As you can see, they extend from the end forward. And then as these overflow records fill, when let's say this overflow record fills right here, we're going to generate another overflow record. Now it gets actually even more complicated than that. Once we have a Pi tag that's generated more than three overflow records, then we consider that such a busy tag, we start to treat it a little bit differently. We change this primary record into an index record. We basically take all the data out of it, move that data into an overflow record, and instead the primary record then becomes an index into where you would find the data in these overflow records. So that's going to continue on and on, and as you can see, as time goes on, these overflow records are going to eventually fill, and when they finally fill to a user definable amount, when they finally fill to the point at which we have very little room left, then at that point we do an archive shift. Now we do allow a little bit of space in here, as you can see, because we do want people to still be able to add data later on, manual input data that may be out of sequence, for example. But that's basically how the primary and overflows are created. We first create these primary records, and we do that at the time that we first initialize the system, the archive, and then over time the overflow records are generating from the end of the record backwards. So actually, if you look at the record numbers, the overflow records are going to start at the end of this list coming backwards, and some of our utilities will show this.